everyone! Welcome back to IntegralCalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about finding integrals of inverse hyperbolic functions. And in this particular problem, we have the integral of e to the x over the square root of e to the 2x plus 1. And this becomes a hyperbolic function because we're going to end up making a u substitution with this problem, which is going to get us to a point where there's going to be a hyperbolic function involved in the integral. So in this particular problem, we'll go ahead and make a u substitution where u is going to be equal to e to the x. And then, of course, when we take the derivative to get du, we'll end up with the same thing, e to the x, because the derivative of e to the x is itself. So we get e to the x dx. And then we want to solve this for dx by dividing both sides by e to the x. So we'll get dx equals du over e to the x. And now we can go ahead and plug these things back into our integral. So we know that e to the x is equal to u, so we plug that in the numerator. And then in the denominator, we have e to the 2x plus 1. Well, e to the 2x, let's go ahead and write that over here. E to the 2x is the same thing as saying e to the x times e to the x, or that's also the same thing as e to the x squared, right? So we can go ahead and change e to the 2x into u squared. So we get u squared plus 1 under the square root sign in the denominator. And then for dx, we'll go ahead and substitute and get du over e to the x. Now the goal of u substitution is obviously to get everything in terms of u, but we still have this e to the x hanging out here. What we need to remember is that we set u equal to e to the x in the first place. So even though it was left here in our equation with dx, we can go ahead and change this e to the x into u, right? Because u is equal to e to the x. So we change it into u, and now we have a u in the denominator and a u in the numerator, which will cancel with one another. So what we're left with is the integral of 1 over the square root of u squared plus 1 du. And what's great about this is that we've now gotten to a point, notice that our integral currently matches the formula that we have up here. And this formula tells us that the integral of 1 over the square root of u squared plus 1 is going to be equal to the inverse hyperbolic sine function of u plus c. So we can go ahead and integrate, and what we'll get is the inverse hyperbolic sine function of u. And then we have to always add c to account for that constant of integration. Now we need to go ahead and plug back in for u. We know that it's equal to e to the x. So we'll get the inverse hyperbolic sine function of e to the x and go ahead and leave that plus c there. But that's it. That's our final answer. So the trickiest part about integrals that involve inverse hyperbolic functions is converting your integrals to a point where they match a formula that gives you an inverse hyperbolic sine or an inverse hyperbolic function. So getting your integral to this point here is going to allow you to easily take the integral because we know that the integral of that is the inverse hyperbolic sine function of this u variable here. So this goes for the other inverse hyperbolic functions as well. They all have a corresponding formula that will, when you take the integral, give you the inverse hyperbolic cosine function, as well as all of the other trigonometric identities. So we transformed our integral to the point where we got this right here, and we knew from the formula that the integral of that was the inverse hyperbolic sine function, so we could easily go ahead and take it. So this is our final answer here. I hope this video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!